See you again, and what are we there? It's the week after Easter, and I think I saw you, was it Easter Saturday?
Thursday.
Oh, the Thursday before Easter.
You were going to leave, and then you made room for him because he was in agony.
Yeah.
With his leg, and we rang everywhere and couldn't get in anywhere, and he said, well, I'll cancel my, he was going to leave at 11 or so, and he said, come on up, and so we travelled to Brisbane to see him.
And got a result. Joseph, please explain. You were in a great deal. I know you were in absolute agony when you came in. Yeah, my heart cried out for you. So.
And in a motorised chair?
That was, you've been in pain for some several weeks, is that right?
7 years.
Yeah, and could you describe the pain and what, efforts you'd gone to help resolve the pain?
Really, really bad pain.
Spasmy
and really cramped too. And I've been on a walking stick for a few weeks and then...
Couldn't live without painkillers.
Yeah, had to have Panadol and then I went into my go-go, my motorized chair. And then I came here and well, Mum said it's either a miracle, big coincidence, or you here. But I'm better.
That night, what happened the Thursday night, Bart? You were in pain.
Thursday night, it was real bad and I didn't know. I thought it didn't help at all, but then, yeah. I just walked the other day.
And you were jumping on the trampoline, yes?
Yeah, and I'm jumping on the a few days ago.
Yeah.
Before that,
yeah. Yeah, a few days.
When we got it.
That's great news, mate. Oh, look, I really appreciate you taking the time out and speaking to us. And yeah, I'm very grateful that you're feeling much better. Thanks,
Tips. He's had no pain since, which is a miracle, because he's been in constant pain. We've been to every specialist, every doctor. Our GP said, look, don't even come to me anymore. You have to go to specialists. Then that's when Keith said, well, I've heard about acupuncture. And I went, oh, I don't believe in all that stuff. And he said, it's science. It's not just, you know. And Keith's the mathematician in the family. Anyway, and that's when we said, well, let's try. We went to one quack the day before, a guy that was in it set up in a mall. And as soon as we went in for the appointment, he came out and I said, don't touch his leg. He was in agony.
And he grabbed my leg and pushed his thumb right on it.
Joe was in spasms for 2 days, and that's when I said, you've got to do something. That's when we got in contact with him.
Right on my leg.
But yeah, he just straight away went, and I said, what did you do that for? And he goes, oh no, I'm a professional. And I said, you've got to listen to people, because I'm afraid what's going to happen tonight. And then that night he was in absolute agony, and I rang him the next day and said, listen, Jack, you actually, hurt Joe. And he goes, oh, no, I didn't press hard. And I said, don't worry, I'm not a litigator. I'm not going to sue you. I'm just telling you that Joe doesn't trust you. He's not coming back.
It was what we called the Louis
didn't even have
imposter.
An appointment. And that's when we called him the imposter.
The Louis imposter.
A Louis imposter, yeah. And then that's when, we tried. And then we looked up the internet and we saw Alan's credentials. And Keith said, hey, this guy looks good. And where is he? In Brisbane. Oh, I don't care where he is. I said, just let's go, because he was just like, oh, someone's got to help me. I was going through pills. It cost me $90 just to get these LYICRA or something pill. And they're a special thing that can only be prescribed. $90, right? He hasn't had one of them since. I only bought that on the Thursday, dump. And he hasn't had one pill. I've gone through so much Panadol. It's like a chemist at my house. He hasn't had one Panadol. It's just insane, really, truly, Alan, insane. So we're grateful.
Great news. Thanks very much, guys. More of the same, I say.
Yeah.
Okay. Take care.
Happy Easter. Thank you.